Hello everybody, my name is Denis and you are watching Close to AlgoTrading. Last time we had a short introduction to reinforcement learning. Today we will create a simple trading environment for our agent. First, we must think about what represents the trading environment. Is it only the price data, or maybe we will have a complete order book, news and rumors from Twitter? Second, what kind of action our agent can perform? Should it be only buy and sell actions, or maybe we also can skip some steps? And third, what is the target and how we will define rewards? Actually, in the real world, our environment has a continuous state space. But let me keep the environment as simple as possible, so we can understand how it is working and what we have to implement. First of all, instead of using a real price, I will use a generated random walk process. I will use only 20 values, which represent simulated daily prices. The episode will start from the middle of this process. It means the initial state will have 10 historical prices, and invisible prices will be filled with 0. On each step, the new price will be added to the array. The episode will be finished when all 20 prices are visible for the agent. It means that we have only 10 steps until our episode is finished. Also, the state will have the information about our open position. Let's use one hot encoding and say, if we have 0,0, we don't have any open position. 1,0, we have a long position, and 0,1, the short position is open. Well, what kind of action we normally want to perform for trading? Buy and sell, skip when we are waiting for the best price, and close if we want to close our open position. If we don't have any open position, the agent can buy or sell a stock. If we already have an open position, the agent can only skip or close this position. It means, in this case, the action sell or buy will be equal to the skip. So, the goal for our agent is maximum profit in 10 days. Let me define reward as a daily profit or loss. Well, now when we have an idea of what our environment is and how it behaves, let me go to the implementation part. As I said earlier, I want to use a TF agent. The TensorFlow agent team prepared a good introduction on how to develop a suitable environment for the TF agent. Please check it if you want to understand the code better. I want to apply one of the standard agents, and the simplest way will be to create a standard Python environment. The interface that all Python environments must implement is in PyEnvironment. So, let's create our environment by inheriting it from PyEnvironment. The first function that we need to implement is init. Here we define all variables and init states. But what is more important, here we also specify our action and observation specifications. As you may see, the action space has 4 different actions and has a minimum and maximum values set to 0 and 3. Observation spec describes our environment state. The price is starting from 0, but doesn't have any maximum limit. Also, the data type is float. If we want our environment to work with the TF agent, we should return our action and observation specifications. The next important function is reset. Reset function should bring your environment in the initial state. It's very important to implement this function correctly. And the function that does the most important job? Step. Step function receives an action as an input parameter. Right here, we are implementing how our environment changes. As you may see, here I have the implementation of all actions and calculate profit and loss. The step function returns a time step which consists of observation. This is a part of the environment state that the agent can observe to choose its action at the next step. Reward. The agent is learning to maximize the sum of these rewards across multiple steps. Step type. It can be either first, mid, or last, to indicate where this time step is the first, intermediate, or last step in the sequence. And discount. As you may see, here we have two different returns. The first one is used for intermediate steps, and the second one is used for the last steps in our episode. After we create our environment, we have to validate it, so we can find and fix bugs. For validation, we can use validate py environment from the util package. Also, it will be good to check our environment specifications. If everything is fine, we can check how our environment is working with different actions. It's really helpful for debugging and validating that everything is working the way you expected. So, our environment is ready to use. I did some tests with a simple DQN TensorFlow agent. And here are the results. Well, after 2000 steps, the agent shows acceptable performance. But here we have only one time series that the agent should learn. Pretty simple. If we add the second time series and run 2000 steps, we will get not really good results. But after 100,000 steps, it looks much better. Well, that's all for today. I hope this video was interesting for you, and see you in the next one. Bye!